Hello everyone, welcome back. Today we will discuss about differential bending and torsion box. First we will discuss what is meant by differential bending. As you all know, for an aircraft wing, it should withstand bending, torsion and transverse load. Bending is mainly due to the distribution of lift load or pressure load. Torsion is due to the movement of control surfaces and pitching and rolling moment. And transverse load is mainly due to the presence of engine as well as the fuel tank. And you know that for an aircraft wing, we have different types of structural members. We have ribs, which can take care of the shear load, spar, which can take care of bending load. Then we have stringers, which can take care of your bending loads. And it also increases the strength of the entire wing. We have a case here. If a wing section is having only one single spar, okay, we have a section of wing here and it is subjected to a torque in anti-clockwise direction and we have only a single spar. Okay, so this section of wing will fail under torque load because due to this torque load the wing can undergo twisting. You can see here this dotted line. And this is the wing which has undergone the twisting of the wing. Okay, so this section of wing will fail due to the action of torque load because we have only a single spar. And for that purpose, that's the reason why we are using multi-spar wing or a wing which consists of more than one spar. A multi-spar wing or a wing with having more than one spar also will undergo twisting because of something called differential bending. You can see in this figure, we have a section of wing which is subjected to a torque in anti-clockwise direction. And we have the front spar and the rear spar here. Due to this torque load, you can see here, the rear spar will be having an bending moment or a bending stress, bending load acting upwards, and we have on the for a front spar a bending moment acting downward, okay, or a bending stress or a bending load acting downwards, and this is called the differential bending, that is due to upward bending on the rear spar and the downward bending on the front spar will create a differential bending on the entire wing section. This also will create a certain amount of twist. For this reason, we need to use something called a torsion box, which can effectively withstand the torque load as well as the bending load. And you are aware that the wing should always carry both torque load as well as the bending load. So we need a section which can carry both the torque load as well as the bending load, and that's the reason why we are using something called a torsion box, which can effectively carry the torsion load as well as the bending load. And you are also aware that the most efficient section for bending is always an I section because we have a high section modulus, and the most efficient section for torque is a circular section. Okay, so you can see I have one simulation for you people. Sorry. In this simulation, we have a hollow cylinder and I have given one rectangular cut at the center of this particular structure and I am applying a torque load. You can see here, we have a rectangular cut at the center. When you are applying this torque load, the rectangular cut will be converted to a diamond shaped cut. Okay, it will change the shape to a diamond. It means that this is undergoing a pure shear. You can see here, this is converted to a diamond shape. You can see here, it's converted to a diamond shape. That is, the cylindrical shape will be undergoing pure shear under the action of torque load. Okay. So basically, a torsion box is a closed section which can resist both bending and torsion. So for aircraft, we can't use a cylindrical section because it cannot withstand the bending load. So we use a closed section which is effective in withstanding both torque as well as bending. And basically, torsion box is an assembly of skin and spar. Okay, the skin of the wing and the spar of the wing. It's an assembly of skin and spar. And this is a torsion box, which consists of the skin of the wing. Second member is your spar cap. Third member is your spar web. Fourth one is this one, that is your stringers. And last one is ribs. Okay, so the torsion box consists of the skin of the wing. Second one is the spar cap. Third one is spar web. Fourth one is stringers. Fifth one is ribs. And this will be having certain function. For a first one is thicker skin, and it can carry your aerodynamic load, and it can carry your shear load basically. Second one is your cap, or your spar cap. It's also called degenerated spar cap because the thickness of the spar cap is very less here, and it can carry your bending load. Then you have the thicker spar web. It can take care of your spar shear load as well as bending load. Stringers. These are stringers here. These are spar web. Stringers are basically axial members which can carry the bending load, and also it increases the strength of the wing. That is, this is the main function of these stringers. And last component is ribs. Ribs are nothing but the members which can provide aerodynamic shape, and this can carry a shear load or a concentrated load. And one of the important advantage of this torsion box is the weight of this box will be very less, and also the torsional stiffness and bending stiffness can be tailored, or we can determine the torsional stiffness and bending stiffness according to the requirement. Okay, what is this torsional and bending stiffness? Torsional stiffness is nothing but the product of shear modulus and polar moment of inertia, and bending stiffness is the product of Young's modulus or modulus of elasticity and second moment of area or moment of inertia. And you have one thing called axial stiffness. Axial stiffness, and this is provided by the stringers. Stringers will provide the axial stiffness. That is nothing but the product of modulus of elasticity and the area. Okay, and these are the facts. So we have the torsion box to basically carry the load of the lift and to transfer the lift from one component to other component. That is to obtain an efficient load transfer, we require torsion box, and it can carry both bending and torsion efficiently. Thank you so much. Please do subscribe the channel and share the videos. Thank you so much. We will see one more of the interesting thing in the next video. Thank you.